Well, North Sea oil firm Faroe Petroleum has agreed to pay Denmark's Dong Energy over $70 million for 5 Norwegian oil and gas producing assets. The acquisitions were funded by an oversubscribed share placing to institutional investors. Well, for more, we are joined by the Chief Executive, Graham Stewart. So, Graham, straight to the interests in those 5 fields. You know, how significant are the proven and probable reserves and the production capability?
Well, they're very significant for us indeed. They'll double our production, more or less. And they'll add a third to our proven reserves and really take us a giant step forward.
And in terms of that giant step forward, how fast will that giant step forward take you? Is it straight into work?
Straight into work. well, we have a lot of work ahead of us now with these new assets. There's already a fairly clear investment program for them that we intend to take a very active role in unlocking value in those assets alone. But also we have our own projects that we've been pursuing that this new cash flow, these new assets will help us to fund. So we have a very exciting program ahead of us.
Okay, so I understand it was a well-supported share placing. You know, which institutional investors of note participated?
Well, I can't say actually who they are, but I can tell you that we were very strongly supported by our existing shareholders. And we're delighted at the level of support that was shown.
So therefore, I'm wondering what this kind of support is saying about the assets or about the sentiment surrounding the sector now?
Well, I think on the assets, it's clear that these assets are a good strategic fit, and people can see that, without much difficulty. But as far as sentiment's concerned, I think the market sees that, or perceives perhaps that the oil price maybe has reached the bottom, and that there may be now a good opportunity to get back in, if you like, and to play the potential recovery going forward. So it's a case of selecting those companies to invest in. So I think the fact that Faroe has remained strong throughout this oil price downturn, we've always kept a strong balance sheet and low level of gearing. That's put us in a strong position to be one of those very few companies who can take advantage of this down cycle and look at growth. So I think the sentiment is an important part of this. It's the investor community has been looking for a move. There have been one or two in the sector, not many, and we're very pleased to have reached this point where we can demonstrate that it's actually really is possible to make a growth move despite this downturn.
Okay, well, you are bucking the trends in so many ways. You talk about, you know, being strong there. How did you avoid falling into debt like your peers?
Well, it's all down to capital discipline. We've got a very experienced team on board who have seen cycles in the past. And it can be tempting to overborrow at times of a high commodity price, and that's clearly happened for many companies. But it is down to that philosophy that it is not always a very wise move to borrow too much money. And so we have strict internal thresholds that we work within, and that's ensured that we've stayed in good health throughout.
Okay, so in terms of the team, what's their view on more acquisitions? Are there more to come?
Well, there are certainly more assets out there. There are in both the UK and Norway, and we focus on both countries. And we have looked at a large number of potential asset acquisitions over the past 2 years or so. Some of those discussions are still ongoing. So, there's certainly scope for there to be more growth acquisitions in the months ahead. But it's all dependent on so many different factors. So I'm, you know, certainly not making any promises, but we are still contemplating, despite having made this move, we're still contemplating further growth through acquisition.
Okay, because you have said in the past there's a lot of life remaining in the North Sea. So I'm taking it, therefore, that this is where you intend to concentrate your efforts and the medium-term attention.
Absolutely. North Sea is our backyard. This is where we intend to stay. We describe ourselves as a pan-North Sea player, so UK and Norway. We made an announcement just 4 days ago on a discovery just to the south of one of our producing fields in Norway, which demonstrates that even though some may assume that all of the potential has already been explored for, that is clearly not the case. I think what's required is focus and a lot of attention to detail in looking at the subsurface and in these various areas. So there is certainly a lot of life left in the North Sea yet.
Okay, and the obligatory Brexit question. Will Brexit benefit North Sea operations?
that's a difficult question. And I'm not qualified to answer it. All I know is that most of our revenues are paid in dollars, and a decent portion of our costs are in pounds sterling, as well as Norwegian kroner. So on balance, I think we come out on top. But I think whether it will help the long term, it really just depends. And I don't think any of us is particularly qualified to answer that question yet.
Okay, thank you very much. Understood. Graham Stewart, Chief Executive of Faroe Petroleum, thank you very much indeed for joining us today.
Thank you.